I haven't been this excited since I started doing this YouTube and game development stuff. I've been doing a lot of tutorials about different game mechanics and how to do specific things with VR, but I feel like I'm misrepresenting how to actually make a VR game. So, to remedy this, and for my sanity, because doing tutorials every single week was starting to get to me and starting to get a little bit boring. So, for the next few months, I'm going to be working on a game of my own. I want to document the process of making a VR game from start to finish, released on Steam for you guys, so you can follow along, see what I do, give me some feedback so you can improve the game that you are going to end up playing eventually, and it'll just be a fun experience. I might just end up streaming some of it too. So if you're interested in following along with me on this game journey for the next few months, then definitely subscribe, because I'm going to be putting out a video at least every week, and in the end, we get to see a finished game come to life. Alright, so in this video, we are doing something a little bit different than what you would probably expect. I'm not starting with a story or a game concept per se. I'm starting with a look. What do I want my game to look like? The idea is to think of marketing from the beginning. I want to have some good looking GIFs and pictures as early as possible so I can start posting them on social media. Maybe you've already seen some of the GIFs that I've been posting about this little landscape that I've created, but the idea is to have a good looking game first so that you can hook an audience, and then they'll stay around to see, oh, okay, well, what's this about? But the first thing that you always see when you are judging a game is you're like, does it look cool? So today we're going to try to go for that look. And I've always been about realism, so we're going to make a pretty realistic looking game, but I want it to look beautiful as well. So we're going to see if we can do that in VR. So let's jump in. Oh, and one more thing that I forgot to mention is if you are a Patreon game gremlin, you will get exclusive alpha access to this game before anybody else. You get to play test it with me and give me some feedback and tell me what you think about the game weeks and maybe months before everyone else gets access to it. So if you are interested in helping to be one of the first playtesters, then check out my Patreon down in the description, and let's jump into the game. All right, obviously I'm using Unity for this project, and I'm gonna get a build up and running. We're gonna start with a 3D project because some of the assets that I want to use, specifically Aura 2, only uses 3D. The URP and the HDRP render pipelines. That sounds kind of redundant. HDRP, high definition render pipeline. Anyway, the URP and HDRP do not play well right now with some other render pipelines and like the visuals and whatnot. They're having a little trouble is what I'm trying to say with the pipelines. So we're gonna stick with 3D, the built-in render pipeline for now. I'm gonna download a bunch of packages. So this takes a minute, but the main one that I'm gonna be using for today's video is going to be Gaia Procedural Worlds. I'm going to leave a link to this down in the description. It is an amazing asset and makes creating huge, beautiful worlds very simple. I've played around with it before, and you can make a beautiful mountain terrain or island or hill or valley or whatever you want to make procedurally generated, and it looks beautiful. They have a little stamping tool to just help you shape the world a little bit better than if you were just, you know, playing around with the terrain tool. And also it has biome spawning and everything like that, so it's pretty incredible. So the idea behind this game is I want it to be fairly short. I don't want to spend a ton of time developing it. I just want this to be a first, well-rounded, good game that I release on Steam and takes maybe 30 minutes to an hour to run through and finish. I'm thinking story-driven. That's really all I have at this point. Just simple mechanics, story-driven game. So we're gonna kind of shape our world around that idea. I'm gonna do this for desktop for now. Ideally, I would like to optimize it for Oculus and be able to run that, because Oculus is the most popular VR headset. I'm going to try to optimize for that, but first we're going to start out with PC. Just release it on Steam. That's where the where I plan on releasing it. And then maybe if I can get it to a standalone version that will actually work on the Oculus Quest 2, then I'll release it on SideQuest and AppLab, or at least itch.io. So let's make an island. We're going to pick from the island dropdown, and then I'm going to stamp this one. And then I'm just going to go down here and click spawn biome. I picked the alpine forest biome back in the manager a couple pages ago, and I'm just gonna spawn this biome. It has some built-in culling, which is nice, and then we're gonna go back to the Gaia manager and create a runtime. This one's going to have a flying camera, and so we're going to be able to switch back and forth between this flying camera and then the XR rig that we add a little bit later. And then I'm not going to add a sky because I want to use Aura 2 for skies because it is incredible. And then I actually need to go back to the project settings and go to the player input and switch it back to both, because the flying camera actually uses the old input system. And then we have Aura 2, so I'm going to convert all of the cameras and lights that Gaia brought in and switch them over to Aura cameras and lights, which this basically just adds the Aura component to each light and camera. And then I'm just going to select the dawn scene, and it really dramatically changes the environment. And Aura tends to be very heavy on the fog, so we're going to go to the camera settings and the fog settings and dial those down a little bit, so it's a very fine, misty, you know, morning fog, not a super dense, like, you know, it just rained fog. Once we get that fine-tuned, I'm going to download Hurricane VR, Hexabody, and Final IK. Hurricane VR is going to be the framework for my virtual reality input systems and doing any kind of interactions. Hurricane VR is going to be used for that. Hexabody was built by the same people who made Hurricane VR, and it is a fantastic VR movement system. So it's very much Boneworks-like, physics-based. You can climb natively by just pushing your hands down on stuff. You can crouch, jump, do all those things. Hexabody is great for that, and it works seamlessly with Hurricane VR. And then Final IK also works seamlessly with Hurricane VR. And eventually, once I get the story mapped out and figure out who the main character is going to be and who the player is going to be, then we're going to use Final IK to hook up that player to the controls and to the XR rig, and the player then becomes that character. And then Final IK will handle the procedural walking and the limbs and all that kind of stuff. For Hurricane VR, we're going to set up layers. We need to set the physics settings and the collision matrix, which they make it super easy with this little input system. And then we're going to go to the Hurricane VR integrations and import the Hurricane Hexa integration. And this will give us a pre-built XR rig that is made to just drag and drop into your scene, and it has Hurricane VR and Hexabody both integrated into it. So this is the whole thing minus Final IK, which we're going to add later. And then we also need to make sure to add this camera to Aura 2 as well. And now we can test the scene, walk around, see how beautiful the trees are. All of this was procedurally generated with Gaia. All the trees, all the grass, all the flowers, any butterflies or birds you see flying around, all of that was procedurally generated by Gaia. If I had my headphones in, you would also be able to hear the sounds coming off of this. It's just a forest sounds, and there's some birds chirping and that kind of stuff. Gaia brings all of that in built in. If you have the money, or even if you want to get Gaia 2, I'm using Gaia Pro, but if you even want to get Gaia 2 and you have the money, I highly, highly recommend it. The links are down in the description. It makes world building 1,000 times easier. This would have taken me, you know, weeks to make something that looks this good, and it has all the terrain in the biomes, and the terrain is colored the correct way and painted nicely. This would have taken me weeks to do by hand, so having this built in is definitely worth the money. So not bad for a few hours of work, huh? We have this beautiful island to write a story on, and we have a capable character controller and VR framework to work off of, and we can do a lot of drag and drop stuff without even having to write a single line of code. I'm kind of thinking that the only code that I'm going to need to write is a game manager that just makes sure that all the different points of interest are hit in this story, and any dialogue that we have or, you know, voiceovers renders and happens at the right time. So now we need to decide on a story, and this is where you come in. I don't have a story in mind. Right now what I'm thinking of is I just want a small, you know, story-driven game where you walk around and you have to at least hit these 4 or 5 points of interest on the island. I don't know if it's going to be a escape the island kind of thing, or if you were just trying to figure out why you're on the island, or if you inherited the island. Help me figure out the story. Drop your suggestion down in the comments. I will reply. I reply to every single comment on every single one of my videos. So if you have a suggestion, or if you just want to provide your input, I would love to hear from you. If you're interested in following the development a little more closely, I have a Trello board that I have linked down in the description as well, if you want to check that out and see what specifically tasks are done, being done, how close are we to alpha, that kind of stuff. The next few videos are going to be coming up with a story. I will let you know if you're going to encounter spoilers ahead of time. We're going to set up a Steam page together, a website. We're going to do some marketing together. I'm going to, set up all the points of interest across this island and create different gameplay around that, wrap the story around those. So that'll be another video or two. And then I'm going to tie it all together with a game manager, make a dope trailer, add some UI elements, and do some playtesting. Let all the Patreons jump in on alpha, and then let you guys jump in on the beta if you want. And then we're going to release it to Steam, see how that does, and I will let you know all the numbers that I am allowed to reveal to you guys. I want this to be a very transparent development process. You guys are going to see the whole thing. It's all going to be documented, and I think this is just going to be a really cool experience for you, and really exciting, and breathe some life into this channel, because doing tutorials day after day is good for you guys, and I know you guys love the tutorials, and I'm still going to keep doing them, but I'm going to take a little bit of a break and make this game. So I hope you will stick around for this journey, and I'm interested to see what your story ideas are. So let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next week.